Well, now let's turn to the grand final. And the Swans and their supporters have painted the town red and white, celebrating through the night after their nail-biting victory. They showed off the silverware in South Melbourne this morning before taking the party to Sydney.
They came in their thousands, hoping to get their hands on this.
Go, Swannies! Go, Sydney!
And catch a glimpse of their favourite premiership players. Some hadn't been to bed after a big night of celebrations.
We've celebrated with strangers in the street. It doesn't matter because we are a family.
The boys were a little worse for wear, but still wearing the Premier's grin.
A few dark glasses, but, you know, I think that's to be expected. We had a good night last night.
No, it's pretty cool to turn up there at South Melbourne and see all the people down here. It's amazing. It's an amazing feeling.
Ben McGlynn lapping up the glory, gracious about being benched for the grand final.
No sleep last night, but couldn't be happier and proud of the boys.
The ruckman was running a little late, but made quite an entrance.
Yeah. What catches out? Oh!
He squeezed every last second out of the post-match party and missed the fan day bus.
The Swans haven't played a match here at the old South Melbourne Cricket Ground since 1981, but today's turnout shows the loyalty and passion hasn't faded.
That's a great credit to the old South Melbourne people that they've been able to foster this supporter base and see the new generation coming through.
We're at the spiritual home of the Swans and that's what counts.
Club stalwarts happy the northern migration has paid off.
The reason that we were for the move was about success for our club. We are extremely proud.
Never felt better in my life.
And of course, this victory's a tale of two cities. After the party in South Melbourne, the players flew back to a hero's welcome in Sydney. The harbour town honours its adopted sons and their imported football code. For one diehard fan, the victory will last a lifetime.
What better tribute to my beloved Swans?
Fulfilling a grand final promise, adding to his bond with the Bloods. Yasmin Payton, 10 News.
For the runners-up, the mood at Glen Ferry Oval was sombre and reflective. The Hawks acknowledged the Swans' enduring performance and vowed to fight on next year.
In a show of support and solidarity, thousands gathered in the Hawks' heartland.
We thought, just like you guys at the 10-minute mark of the last quarter, that we're maybe a really big chance to bring home our 11th Premiership Cup, but it wasn't to be.
Feeling a bit sore and sorry, the captain addressed the crowd with no shades or caps to help hide the team's hangover of disappointment.
Look, it's a frustrating way to finish considering we played such good footy throughout the year.
Honey the Poodle was among supporters still wearing the club colours with pride.
Well, our boys played the best they could. They didn't go out there to lose. They went out there to play their heart and soul out, and they did.
It was a chance to reflect.
I think Buddy should have marked a couple more marks and kicked a couple more goals.
It's terribly sad, upset.
And get close to idols.
Buddy Franklin and Sioria Oli.
Fans here are philosophical. It's been a great season. It was a solid effort yesterday and, as I say,
there's always next year.
Go Hawks!
After coming so close during the game's roller coaster ride,
didn't talk really much, sat at home.
Brown and gold clothes, hats and scarves were in demand.
We've got such loyal fans, as you can see them all here, and they're always here for us, and we really appreciate it.
The team will rely on these supporters to spur them on in 2013.
Hopefully they'll be bigger and stronger next year, and we can go one better.
Melanie Davies, 10 News.
And the contrast between victory and defeat were even more extreme last night in the emotional hours after the final siren. Sydney fans kicked off celebrations at the hallowed scene of the win as the MCG became a giant party venue.
A rock star reception at the home of football. On an unforgettable night for fans and players.
This is unbelievable!
Brown and gold was hard to spot at the free party. A sea of red and white soaking up that good feeling.
2 in 7 years, people don't seem in 50.
It's the first final we've ever been to, so it's great.
On came the swan song. Then the rendition.
Shake out the thunder of the sky.
While one Paul Kelly took centre stage at the G, another sung praises at the club's official function.
we were able to hang in, and I think that's the strength of the boys. You know, they just never give up.
Bob Skilton says he'd happily trade in his three Brownlows for a Premiership Cup.
I'm only a little short ass, but I felt 10 foot tall.
A fellow Brownlow medalist dropped in on the way to a tattooist.
I've got 2005 here, and 2012 will go under. I'd booked 2006, but I had to cancel that one.
Supporters kicked on at their traditional watering hole.
We've come down from Newcastle to watch the grand final here in the Bloods territory.
But Hawks fans didn't stick around at Glenferrie Oval after a devastating day.
It was tragic.
Heartbreak, to be honest.
I don't know, I'm a bit lost for words.
No words were needed to sum up the players' feelings at Hawthorn's official event. Instead of the party they'd hoped for, a night to reflect on what could have been. Trent Dan, 10 News.